Hey guys, Thomas from Team Soccer Ops here, coming at you with a balanced analysis for January 2020. A lot of people don't like this list. I have a lot of players who are either taking a break or quitting from the game. Might be a knee-jerk reaction from this list, but I'm going to get right into it and tell you guys what's meta, what's not. Before I get into the video, if you guys could follow my Twitter, leave a like and subscribe, and if you guys are buying cards off TCG player, use my link in the description, helps out the channel. First thing we're gonna go to is Thunder Dragon. Now the deck's dead. If you bought Ulti Colossus, I feel sorry for you. Not that sorry, but a little bit. Rip, what's it called, Jason from Team Sakurasso. Your deck won't actually be missed too much. Now the deck basically just what it does right now is it makes Titan, you sit on Titan, and you just pass. I guess if you play it with dangers and depending on your build, you can maybe end with an Opelousa if you play it differently now. But just play another deck. I believe Konami hit this along with many other decks because they want to move all these decks aside for the new decks coming out in our more sets like Eternity Code and all that, except for Orcist apparently. But yeah, speaking of Orcist, they're still tier 1. They hit the one not problem deck, probably the deck that people saw as the problem the most. The Harpoor Ban does hurt, however. I am not going to sit here and say Orcist got off scot-free. However, they're going to breathe and live just fine into the new format. So first off, what they basically have to do is they can't just get interrupted as much, and they're going to struggle more, especially during the mid-game. So, but however, they're still going to be able to make their Galatea, the Omnigate, and set up their board, you know, and interrupt you, because they still have Babel, which a lot of players want banned, which I agree upon. However, I sadly was right, I really didn't want to be right, that Babel wouldn't get banned because they just didn't, they weren't going to do this. Konami doesn't like to do the logical thing that often. So, If you hold on to your Orcist, congrats, you won. Next up is Sky Striker. Now, well, actually, before Sky Striker, very quickly, Pendulums, they're dead. Riptide from Team Sakurasso, but he only plays Pendulum decks. He's quitting for the time being, so I'm a little salty over this list because a lot of my team members were either going to take a break or just quit the game, and that kind of, same with friends, and that kind of upsets me a little bit. So, you know, Endymion, you're not going to see that in the top tables either. But Sky Strikers, now, I believe you're still going to see this a little bit. However, a lot of people are moving away from the deck because it has no engage. It has a lot of its cards limited. Kagari is back to 3, which, I mean, you could get your Widow Anchor back, which is cool and everything. But the deck is not going to have the recursion and the card advantage that it once used to have. And because of that, I really do see Sky Strikers finally breaking away from the meta. Yeah, after all this time. However, I do still think that I could see them still getting a couple tops. But for the most part, I think they're going to be gone. Now, very quickly, I just want to say, if I actually won this ban list, I just want to do a quick stupid thing, but I have, these are my pot of avarices. I had them back in the day. I got them for very cheap. There's one super, one common here. First day, it was really nice. But however, I won on this right here. And this card's absolutely beautiful. I got my Near Mint Ulti Tour Guide for about 60. It's about 140 now. Because this ban list made everything spike up. Moving forward, Altergeist. I believe that Altergeist are going to be at a good spot for Tier 1. I saw this list and after my live reaction and hearing two people cry, who have already named, I sat down, I took my Altergeist core, I got my strikes and warnings, my strikes, my warnings, my judgments, my extravagances, my impermanences, and I built the deck. After that, I went to locals today, and I got first place. I actually 2-0'd everybody, which almost never happens. So, yeah, I think Altergeist are in such a good position right now, because everyone's struggling, but this deck is still as solid as it was. I mean, yes, it does have the one Faker, and that does suck sometimes. Because if the Faker gets banished, like, you're just sitting there like, oh, great, so we're playing the long game now. However, I believe that this is a very good deck going into, you know, the new format. And oppressive decks, and the deck, especially Altergeist, are always going to figure out some place, I believe, in the meta. I think they're going to be a good contender for Tier 1, if not Tier 1. Spirals, with the new support from our legendary duelist. I think they're insane. I really, and with the hype and how people have been playtesting it, whoever has these cards, as long as you have enough people, they're going to get a couple spots in around top 16, top 8. I think this is going to be meta, so we're going to have Spirals, Altergeist, and Orcists for our new meta. I just want to do a quick thing. I can't talk about Ignisters because I'm not knowledgeable enough, but Plunder Patrol, while it's not a bad deck, it needs more, and it's not going to be competitive. It's the only thing I'm going to talk about for what's coming out in the meta, because we're getting Ignition Assault very soon. I think a lot of people are going to play it at a casual level. I could get maybe a top 32 because, you know, you really never know when you're looking at top 32, top 16, if you have a certain amount of players. But again, Heroes didn't get a top, so, you know. I believe that that might be an okay deck, but I don't think it's going to be meta at all. True Draco, a lot of people are just going to shut off their fucking brains and just... The Ignister Diagram. Diagram limit, I get it, hurts. However, it's not the biggest deal. They're still going to be able to plus and pop off. They do have Card and Demise hit, though, which Card and Demise I feel like is ban-worthy. Honestly, I feel like it's a very degenerate plus two. And I really never saw it as healthy for the game. However, maybe I still see, you know, True Dracos, even with those kind of indirect hits, or at least one indirect hit. I see True Draco still, you know, getting a couple tops here and there, which sucks because I feel like it's just one of the most brain-dead decks in Yu-Gi-Oh! Leave a like if you agree, or tell me why it's not in the comment section below. I hope there's no comment actually telling me that, unless it's sarcastic, but yeah. I see Subterror also being looked at if enough people think for a bit. I really do definitely see people going back to it because it fell out of favor. But it was a good deck, and it can perform well. We do know this. And I believe with how badly the meta is right now and how everything went down, I do think that Subterrors can actually make a comeback. Depending. It just depends if people remember the deck. And the last thing I'm going to say very quickly before this video ends is Mech Knights, I believe, are going to definitely be up there because you still get pluses. We still have time for Master World 5. I think a lot of people are going to look at Mech Knight something for, or just maybe even Mech Knights was like a small mix with something else for a competitive deck along with Heroes, because now I feel that because we have all these decks pushed out of the way, including Salamon Great, which I actually forgot to talk to you guys about that. Salamon Great's very strong deck. However, they can still play and set up their one interrupt. However, a lot of people are moving away from it. I still think you're going to see the occasional top, but again, people really were upset about the Stallion Ban. I think it was stupid. I didn't really see why this deck particularly needed a huge hit. I never saw people complaining about it. I do get a small hit, but I think this was a very uncalled ban. But they just wanted to ban one of they went very ban heavy, just because they really did want to make room for the new decks. Rip Brilliant Fusion, by the way. I played a Rogue Mage, just wanted to bring you guys a deck profile of that, but now I have to change the whole build. So that's great. Another deck that I want people just to think about as our last ones is I really do think stuff like Cyber Dragon Crusader and OTK decks are going to be really good, because Cyber Dragon's still a great deck, can always get a top 8. We've already known this. We still have Super Poly at 3 as well, which helps them out. And we have Crusader, which might not be as strong, but it's still a really good deck. I always see Crusader at maybe like table 7 or table 8. Table 7 to 8 when I go to a regionals. And I see them, you know, maybe X1, X2. So I still see this deck performing. I believe with all the other hits to the decks I've just mentioned, they might get some more hits. Overall, I'm not super happy with this list. But just to conclude, I think Orcist, Altergeist, and along with a few other decks, along with Spirals, are definitely going to come up there to tier 1. All the other ones are going to be grasping for another spot right above there. Along with all the decks that got hit are either straggling or you're like Thunder Dragons and completely dead. Anyway, guys, leave a like if you guys enjoyed. Subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next video. And tell me what you guys thought about this ban list. That's what I really want to know. I wish we got Light Stage 2 at least 2. If we got Light Stage 2, that would be amazing. But yeah, I'll see you guys later. Peace.